Hello students, welcome to PNMRC e-classes. Today we are going to study the rest of the questions of exercise 1.1. So let's start with question number 5, that is, Mohan deposit rupees 2000 in his bank account and withdraw rupees 1642 from it the next day. So how much rupees Mohan deposited? Mohan deposited rupees 2000 in his bank. And how much rupees he withdraws? He withdraws rupees 1642 from his bank. If withdrawal of amount from the account is represented by negative integer, then how will you represent the amount deposited? If withdrawal amount is represented by negative integer, then deposit amount will be represented by positive integers. Find the balance in Mohan's account after the withdrawal. You have to find out the balance in Mohan's account after the withdrawal. Students, as you know, withdrawal money is represented by negative integer. That means minus rupees 1642. So, deposit money is represented by positive integers. That means plus rupees 2000. So, balance in Mohan's account will be rupees 2000 minus rupees 1642. That comes to be rupees 358. Now students, our sixth question is, Rita goes 20 km toward east from point A to point B. From point B, she moves 30 km towards west along the same road. If the distance towards east is represented by positive integer, then how will you represent the distance traveled towards the west? By which integer will you represent her final position from A? Suppose this is a number line. On a number line, if I suppose this is a number line and mark A as 0, so towards east will be positive integers and towards west will be negative integers. So as we move toward 20 kilometers from point A to B, that means plus 20 kilometers from point A to B. Then as we move from point B toward west, 30 kilometers, that means minus 30 kilometers from point A, B to towards the west. Now I will tell you how you have to write in your notebook. First you have to draw the diagram and then start solving it. Students, in this way, first you have to draw a diagram and then start solving it. So as we move towards the east, 20 km towards the east, that means plus 20 km towards the east. And from point B, again we move towards the west 30 km, that means minus 30 km towards the west. Then how will you solve it? You have to solve it like this. Distance toward east from point A is positive. Distance toward east from point A is positive, that is plus 20 km. Therefore, Rita moves 20 km toward the east from point A to B, that is equal to plus 20 km. Distance toward west from point A is negative integer. So Rita moves 30 km west, then it is minus 30 km. We have to find out the final position of Rita. Therefore, final position will be plus 20 plus minus 30 km. Plus minus minus plus 20 minus 30, then again plus minus minus. You have to subtract this 20 from 30. It comes to be minus 10. As you all know, the answer will carry the sign of a bigger number. Here the bigger number is 30 and this 30 carries minus sign. So answer will also carry minus sign. Now student, we are going to solve question number 7. In a magic square, this is a magic square. Each row, column and diagonals have the same sum. Check which of the following is a magic square. You have to check is this a magic square or this one is a magic square. Student, as I'm telling you, this is a magic square. Now you might be thinking that why did I say so? So that is because if you try to add the numbers present in a row wise, then that answer will be similar to the answer that comes to be adding column wise. in this type or in a diagonal way, this type, in this way. So let's start solving it. Students, first you have to draw this magic square and then start adding it row wise, then column wise, and in a then last one is a diagonal way. First we will start adding in a row wise. Plus 5, plus minus 1, plus minus 4. As you know, plus minus, minus 1, plus minus, minus 4. Minus minus, plus. That is 4 plus 1 comes to be 5. But answer will carry the sign of a bigger number, and here the bigger number is minus 4. So this will also carry minus 5. 5 minus 5, that comes to be 0. Next question is, minus 5 plus minus 2 plus 7. Minus 5 is equal to minus 5 plus minus equal to minus 2. And then plus 7. Minus minus plus. 5 plus 2, 7. Again, it will carry the sign of a bigger number. And here the bigger number is 5 and it carries the sign of minus. So 7 will also carry sign of minus. Minus 7 plus 7. Answer is 0. Again, third one. 0 plus 3 plus minus 3. Plus minus minus. Again, plus 3 minus 3. Answer is 0. Now we will add column wise. Plus 5 plus minus 5 plus 0 plus minus minus 5 minus 5. That comes to be 0. Second one is minus 1 plus minus 2 plus 3 minus 1 plus minus minus 2 plus 3 minus minus plus 2 plus 1. Answer is 3, but answer will carry the sign of bigger number, and here bigger number is 2, so it will also carry the sign of bigger number, that is minus 3. Minus 3 plus 3, answer is 0. Third one is minus 4 plus 7 plus minus 3 plus minus minus. So minus 4 plus 7 minus 3. I will add this minus 4 and minus 3. Answer is minus 7 plus 7. Then answer comes to be 0. Then in diagonal way, if I add the numbers, then plus 5 plus minus 2 plus minus 3 plus minus minus plus minus minus. Again minus minus plus 2 plus 3 minus 5. 5 minus 5, answer is 0. Here minus 4 plus minus 2 and plus 0. Plus minus minus. So minus minus plus 4 plus 2, answer is minus 6. So in a diagonal way, if I add the numbers, answer does not come to be 0. So this is not a magic square. Another magic square that you have to do it yourself, and then you have to tell me, is that a magic square or not? Now students, we are going to solve question number 8. Verify A minus minus B is equal to A plus B for the following values of A and B. You have to tell that A minus minus B is equal to A plus B. It means you have to tell LHS is equal to RHS or not by putting the values of A and B in question. Part 1 of question number 8 is A is equal to 21 and B is equal to 18. We have to put the values of A and B in LHS. LHS is A minus minus B. A is equal to 21 and B is equal to A minus 18. Then minus minus plus. So 21 plus 18 comes to be 39. Now I will put the values of A and B in RHS. RHS is equal to A plus B. I will put the value of A and B in RHS. A is equal to 21 plus B is equal to 18. 21 plus 18, answer is 39. Therefore, I can say that LHS means left hand side is equal to RHS. RHS means right hand side. Now, we will solve second question of question number 8. The value of 8 is 118 and the value of B is 125. LHS is A minus minus B. I will put the values of A and B in LHS. 118 minus minus 125 minus minus plus. So 118 plus 125 answer is 243. Now I am going to solve RHS. RHS is A plus B. Value of A is 118 plus value of B is 125. So 118 plus 125 answer is 243. So we can say that LHS is equal to RHS. The rest two questions, students, that you have to solve it yourself. It is very easy that you can solve yourself. Now, question number 9 is, using the sign of bigger, smaller or is equal to in the box, this one is the box, to make the statement true. A part of question number 9 is minus 8 plus minus 4. Is that greater, smaller or equal to minus 8 minus minus 4? So let's solve it and find out, is it greater, smaller or equal to. Students, first we will solve left hand side of square box. Minus 8 plus minus 4. Plus minus 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 8 minus 4 comes to be minus 12. Answer will carry the sign of a bigger number, and here the bigger number is 8 and it carries the sign of minus. So answer will also carry minus sign. Now I will solve the right hand side of the box. Minus 8 minus minus 4 minus minus plus 8 minus plus again minus. You have to subtract 4 from 8. Answer is minus 4. Answer will carry the sign of a bigger number, and here the bigger number is 8 and 8 carries the sign of minus. So answer will also carry sign of minus. B part of question number 9 is left hand side first. Minus 3 plus 7 minus 19. So again minus 3 will come like this only, minus 7 will come like this only, and minus 19 will come like this only. Again I will add this minus 19 and minus 3, minus 19 minus 3, and then this plus 7. Minus 19 minus 3 is minus 22, and plus 7, minus plus minus, minus 22 plus 7 comes to be minus 15. Answer will carry the sign of the bigger number, and here the bigger number is minus 22. Now I will solve left side of the box. 15 minus 8 plus minus 9 plus minus minus 9. Again plus 15 will come like this only, minus minus plus 9 plus 8 comes to be minus 17. Again I will subtract plus minus minus 15 from 17. Answer is minus 2, and answer will carry the sign of a bigger number, and here the bigger number is 17. So answer will also carry sign of bigger number, that is minus. So student, this was the end of exercise 1.1. You have to solve C, D and E part of question number 9 yourself. Thank you and have a nice day.